into the Space Center, and we see in the distance the huge throbbing VAB.
Yes.
I can keep this tight shot steady.
Wednesday, August 6th. Yay!
That's right.
Day before the launch, we got our press passes. Fuck!
That's right. That's, thank goodness. And there we are. That's pretty cool looking. And here we see the official press passes. And Mark is wearing his.
Oh, yes.
Show it proudly on your breast.
There we are. My breast.
His breasts. So we're now driving along. And we've got, as your attorney, I advise you to move to the left lane. Oh, wait. And we have 01 days to launch, that's right. We just got waved through the gate as I put on my damn press pass.
We're in a freaking security area.
That's
now.
Right, we're in a secured area.
We're now special.
That's right. And let's get another tight shot of that VAB. And that's an extremely nice...
That's a nice Jeep.
Very nice Jeep right there, lucky bastard.
On top of
the expensive rims he's got there.
Could be an astronaut.
Could be.
Ooh. Look, tour vans gone by.
Right, god damn, that's a big building. Jesus Christ. Another tight shot of that. Man. Hey, focus, you piece of shit.
Be property aware.
That's right.
Show you can. You bastard.
God damn, it's big. It'll be really irritating and lots of zooming and panning here.
That's okay.
And we'll be on again as soon as we get closer. As soon as we get a little... Golly. Big old son of a bitch. Dang.
This is a light. Especially cool because most people want to get the
That's right.
Because with metal.
That's exactly right. Here we are. Okay.
Doesn't matter. I like the sign.
That's right. We're on the news media site now. Say, god damn, you better focus, you Japanese piece of shit.
Yeah.
There's people. This thing is still not focusing. Yeah, focus, you bastard. All right, now.
That's right.
We're here for what?
To get the scoop.
The scoop, that's right.
So what's the story on that?
That's the story on them
tapes.
There's the VAB. God damn. We're in an area we've never been into before. CBS News.
Pretty wild.
The NASA Nude Center, a news center. And that looks like the press area will be. And there's the countdown clock that we've all seen. Wow. Do the official stuff tomorrow, right?
Violators will be violated.
That's right. I like that one. That was cool. Okay, we're actually in the press box. The grandstand, I guess. The press grandstand. There's Tim. Going to take a picture of the countdown clock. I don't know if we'll be able to sit up here tomorrow or not, but what the hell. At least we get some of this documented. And in case you're wondering, launch pads right out there. Of course, if the camera would focus, thank you. And of course, the shuttle's covered up right now, but soon enough, it'll be uncovered. Or I'm coming down the grandstand. And,
grandstanding.
He's grandstanding. The VAB. Ooh, ah. The grandstands. The grandstands. Yeah. You might be wondering what this is. Oh, okay. I'm sure you already know what this is. This is the countdown clock. Look at that. Wow. It's big. It's huge. And there's Tim. Sorry, sir. I'll have to ask you to leave the premises. Is that cool? And if we get off to the side, the shuttle's on the pad, we were there. This August 6th, 1997. I'm sorry, sir. May I see your ID? Yeah, be sure to use the flash. That's right. It's got to get the flash. Well, there it is. It's right. It's on your shoulder, man. Ooh, it's on your shoulder. Ooh, the shuttle. Ooh. Cool. There's Tim doing his camera thing. Photos of the shuttle. Ooh. Okay, here we are. August 7th, 1997.
Oh, yes.
Look at all this stuff, man. Here we are. Ready for a launch, I hope. Well, we're ready. The weather might not be. Look at the VAB. So it's early morning, about 6:30 in the morning, and pretty damn cool. And if I zoom around, there's the pad over there. Damn right. NBC News. I have no idea who that is, but
oh, by the way, I just need one more. The cafeteria is which building? That's what I thought. I saw that big building with all those black windows. Hey, one of the.
And Tim on the computer.
Mm-hmm.
All official. All official looking.
That's right.
Now the next interview we have is with Canadian astronaut Bjarni Tryggvason. He is one of the main developers of an experiment that will study how vibration and microgravity affects experiments. And he comments on how a special mount, the weather here in Florida today. Astronaut Bob Cabana is flying in weather reconnaissance aircraft around the Central Florida vicinity, checking out actual locations and making a report back to controllers here in the firing room. Again, the weather conditions we're looking at is the potential for showers in the Kennedy Space Center within 20 miles of the shuttle landing facility, and also the possibility of low cloud ceilings. There seems to be quite a bit of moisture in the area here in Florida. But as the sun continues to heat and warm up the area, the haze and fog should be burning away, and there has been an improvement on the visibility in the area from the shuttle landing facility. So we'll continue to monitor weather conditions. So launch controllers remain optimistic for launch today. Again, no technical problems with the shuttle or flight crew or payload. Everything going from Baikonur a couple days ago, and we'll be docking to the nearest station later on today. That time for this morning, which we could not launch the shuttle Discovery, is at 10:53 a.m. to 10:55 a.m. Eastern. Just a 2-minute period of time that we will be avoiding launching during that time. But we do plan to launch on time at 10:41. Our countdown clock's ready to reflect that launch time. And we do have a 1 hour and 39 minute launch window for today. And
okay, here we are, Tim.
Yes, we are.
Shortly before launch.
That kid gives me another false cue. I'm gonna.
He's a tiles.
SCTV, man.
That's right. So T not minus 9 minutes in holding.
And we heard that poll by NASA Test Director Doug Lyons of the launch team, indicating that they are ready to continue on with launch today.
All right.
Standing by now for Jim Harrington, the launch director, to conduct his poll of the management team.
We're on a poll at this time.
Switches in the orbiter's crew cabin to directly connect the three fuel cells to the essential power buses.
Shuttle Discovery, which includes the first person to ever warn in Iceland to go on the ground. We talked about before, and Jan Davis, who also did the payload commander on this particular mission. Now, my, but it's a crowded day in space.
Pilot Kent Rogers celebrating his 41st birthday today with the launch here. About a minute and a half to launch.
My mother's birthday too.
Is that real?
Mother's 70 today.
About to embark on the 86th shuttle flight.
Yeah, I called her from the press. I
ready to study Earth's little atmosphere on your test robotics.
I found out the pilot's birthday too.
That's great.
We'll try to make the repairs to the space station. By
at T-minus 31 seconds, Discovery's onboard computers will have control of all vehicle functions.
We're at T-minus 1 minute and 8 seconds in counting.
Coming
up in just about 30 seconds or so, what's going to happen is the shuttle will then
T-minus 1 minute
power and internal control. The computers on the shuttle.
All systems are go for launch of Discovery.
After that, it's entirely up to the shuttle to fly herself. You'll see the astronaut very...
T-minus 50 seconds.
Well, believe it or not, when that happens, their hands are in their lap because the shuttle is basically flying itself. It's only during that last few minutes when the shuttle comes into landing, so the commander and the pilot
T-minus 40 seconds
and start to do their thing. Anyway, we're coming up on that point, the auto sequence start here at the Kennedy Space Center. You're listening to live shuttle coverage on 90.7 WMFE.
Cool.
Water will be dumped up to the launch platform in a few seconds to help suppress the sound and shock of the thrust produced by the shuttle at launch. T-minus 15 seconds. 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. We have a go for main engine start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Booster ignition and liftoff of Discovery on the mission to study planet Earth. Houston is now controlling. The roll maneuver is complete. Discovery is now at a head stand on the wings level position.
Thank you.
seconds into the flight, Discovery's three liquid-fueled engines are now back at full throttle, 104% of rated thrust. Discovery now traveling at a speed of 1,900 miles per hour at an altitude of 16 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 13 miles. The next event will be the burnout and separation of Discovery's twin solid rocket boosters. Again, telemetry currently indicating all three main engines, auxiliary power units, and fuel cells continuing to perform well. Discovery now at a speed of 2,800 miles per hour, downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 27 miles.
Amazing. Still see it?
Yeah. Hopefully
we'll
see SRP.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
2 minutes, 15 seconds into the flight.
Discovery, performance is nominal.
Booster officer here in the flight control room confirms good separation of the solid rocket boosters, and Discovery's performance so far in its flight has been as expected. Discovery now downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 53 miles, traveling at a speed of 3,250 miles per hour.
All right.
Discovery, two engine Marone.
Oh, wrong.
To Discovery, you may get additional right arm dilemma manifold messages, no action.
Discovery could now reach the transatlantic landing site at Marone, Spain, in the event that a transatlantic landing was required. However, telemetry continuing to indicate all three engines continuing to perform well. 3 minutes, 17 seconds into its 8.5 minute climb to orbit. Discovery now downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 100 miles at an altitude of about 55 miles. Speed currently 4,100 miles per hour.
Quite shocking. Amazing space technology.
Amazing. Prepare to search for satellite speed.
Ludicrous speed.
Process to start with than one we just had, which was about as clean as you can see in the process of getting ready to launch, and I think that's a great demonstration of an outstanding team here that puts vehicles together and gets them launched on time. As we look at the weather here today, we had just about ideal conditions, launching mid-morning here in Florida, so the weather behaved very nicely for us. There wasn't much question that we were going to have good weather all the way from the start. I also mentioned that
it's been around
the future. We're hopeful we can anchor the launch date that we'd like to pursue for STS-86.
I guess let me rephrase that. Are you holding September 18th at the moment? If I'm going to put in my paper, the next shuttle launch is September 18th, correct, at the moment?
At this moment, the next shuttle launch is September 18th.
Additional questions,
Bill Chin. Let me follow up on that a little bit sideways. I guess we're about an hour away from the Soyuz docking. Is there any less pressure now that the Soyuz is already on the way, it's launched, that you don't have to rush to get up emergency parts if, for example, if there had been a problem with the Soyuz or they had been a delay on that site?
Well, a question probably better posed to the Phase 1 program manager, but my understanding is that we are not in a desperate situation to launch specific equipment or to get it to the Mir at this time.
Well, I hope I'm not.
So glad you asked that question about what NASA means.
That's right. Yes, and I'm still not quite satisfied with the explanation. I don't think that there's a.
Yeah. Oh boy. What's that for? I don't know. It's a conspiracy, I think.
The sweat right out of my clothes.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
That's probably Cronkite or you never know who's
going
to be. Oh,
I know.
There, you know? And all the people, all the original.
I've seen pictures of, like, Walbert Cronkite. And he was one of the most great to see.
Yeah.
So in that center doing reports and stuff.
I know they kept that just for the history, just to have
it.
Just to say that, you know, it's
they have flags from all the different countries and stuff in there. And
I came to say that the thing was tore down and they had all the press area moved in trailers on the other side.
Yeah.